If we're going to issue requests to our API, it's important that we know where it lives and how to access the particular resources that we want to work with. This is where URLs come into play, and URLs are essentially the address of our API. Now, using a combination of URLs, HTTP methods, and some other information inside the requests, ASP.NET Core is able to invoke the right action method inside of the right controller to process our requests. And this is known as routing, and that's what we're going to talk about in this particular video. So why don't we take a look at an example of a URL? This one is coming from Microsoft Graph. And you know, this is an API that allows us to get information from our M365 account. Now, if we break up this URL, we can see that it's made up of a scheme, which lets us know, for instance, what protocol that we're using. There's also a host name that lets us know, well, what domain does this API live under? And lastly, we have the path. The path tells us, how do I get to that resource that I want to work with? So if we read it out, I'm saying I want to issue an HTTP request to Microsoft Graph to get information about my account. Now, using all this information that we've learned so far, let's see how we could apply routing to ASP.NET Core. Let's open up our Web API controller. Now, the recommended way to apply routing to our Web APIs is by using routing attributes. And you might have noticed on line 10, we've had this attribute added for us ever since we created this controller. Now, using routing attributes, we're able to specify the path that we want to associate with our code. So again, on line 10, this particular route attribute is letting us know that our controller is going to be listening to anything that comes on the path /API/ and the name of the controller. In this case, the name of our controller is recipes. If I decided to change the name of my controller and call it something like contacts or products, the name of the path that it would listen to would also change as well. Another option we have is, instead of using this controller syntax that's here, I could remove this and I could just hard code recipes. Now that I've changed this and I have a fixed name, as I change the name of my controller, the name of the path that it's associated with won't change. So you can do that depending on if you want to have that level of consistency. Now, this routing attribute on line 10 applies to the controller, and so therefore it applies to all the action methods inside of the controller as well. But if we wanted to, we can go a little bit more granular and control routing on the action method level. Let's check out this delete method here. Notice I have this HTTP delete attribute. If I wanted to be a little bit more specific, and maybe I wanted to delete everything, I could specify all here in this attribute. And now what will happen is that this will listen to a path of /API/recipes/all. So that whenever I issue my delete request, that's the path that I'll have to use. Another thing that we could do is specify tokens that we want to use as variables. So for instance, let's say I wanted to delete a resource with a particular ID. I could use these curly brackets and give it the name of the parameter or token that I want to use. And now here inside of my action method, I could accept a variable with the same name. And ASP.NET Core will do the job of matching those names together to make sure that the data gets passed into my action method. So now what will happen is that instead of listening to all, now this would respond to requests for delete API recipes/1, API recipes/12, slash whatever you feel like you want to put inside of there. Why don't we go ahead and debug this and see if it works? So I'm going to hit the run button and I'm going to wait for Visual Studio to build my application and spin up that web browser for me. Now that my browser's up, I can see all the various operations for my API. I'll select the delete one since that's the one we want to work with. And notice now here, I also have the ability to add this parameter whenever I try it out. So when I hit try out, and I'm going to put 12 in here, for instance, when I execute that, now it should make a request to /API/recipes/12. Notice it hit my breakpoint. And then when I inspect the value of that particular parameter, it says 12. So ASP.NET Core was able to get that information from the route. And now I could use it to process the request inside of my action method. Now, there's a lot more to learn about routing inside of ASP.NET Core, but I think this is a pretty good foundation for us building web APIs. In the next video, we're going to spend a little bit more time in that Swagger UI and learn how we could really use it to debug our web API projects.